Hello students, in today's video session let us understand architectural development tracks. What exactly is the meaning of this? Obviously you know that architecture, whatever we are observing today or practically applying today, is the end product of last many years work. You know that understanding features of present tracks actually means you have improved upon the previous tracks or previous works of different architectures, isn't it? Let us understand all those tracks. Tracks means what? A roadmap. You know that a person who might be developed very well established today, you will say that he started his work from a small job. Today he has become CEO. This is his track, isn't it? Roadmap. Before he reaches that point, whatever is covered up, no? That is called as tracks. Now, obviously the architectural development, whatever we are talking, will be with some examples. What work was there previously, how it is evolved, what additions are done so as to improve upon, all these are discussed. Generally, there will be 6 tracks for discussion. One is shared memory track, message passing track, multi-vector track, single instruction multiple data track, multi-threaded track, and data flow track. These 6 tracks we will be just studying. Later chapters, many chapters are developed upon these 6 tracks. To today's session, I just give you an introduction of all these tracks. That's all. Let us see the first, that is shared memory track and unshared memory track. Okay. First, the shared memory track, whatever I am talking, he started with Carnegie Mellon University's C.MMP project, in which he started in 1972 with a university. Carnegie Mellon University started this work, where in this project where it was a start of a multiprocessor with a shared memory. It had used 16 processors, 16 PDP processors in parallel with 16 shared memory modules. Okay, this C.MMP project, which was started in 1972, had used 16 processor sharing 16 memory. That means it had uniform memory access module, UMA module or UMA module it had. Okay, and what they used is a special inter-processor interrupt bus. Special inter-processor interrupt bus was used between these processors so as to track the work or to communicate between different processors. Okay, along with the shared memory, this was the special inter-processor interrupt was developed. And then not only the crossbar architecture, but also multiprocessor operating system was developed. Multiprocessor operating system, this is one of the important thing. Multiprocessor operating system was developed for C.MMP project. Okay, this was the start of multiprocessor work with a shared memory. Later what happened, the Cedar project, it was later developed into two. Illinois Cedar project, you can see there, Illinois Cedar project, which was started in 1987, and ultra computers NYU project, 1983 work, whatever was then, those two were the just the next improvement upon C.MMP project. What improvement they have done? See, Cedar project had parallel compilers. Okay, parallel compilers. Cedar project, Illinois Cedar project had parallel compilers as compared to the previous. A development in operating system was done, parallel compilers were developed, and the ultra computers NYU project, whatever had, no, it had a fast network for synchronization among different processors. That's how these two processors developed upon C.MMP. And later Stanford University's DASH project was based upon the Cedar project. Okay, and it had global address space. It had a global address space, and not only that, cache coherent distribution memory was used. And in the same line, you can see Fujitsu VPP 500 as well as KSR, Kendall KSR, which used cache only memory access. These were the development which had taken into other direction. If you see there, initially started with uniform memory access project, and then multi-compiler CEDAR project, and then Stanford's and KSR's cache only memory units were developed. In this way, finally we are reaching a maturation, matured project level with KSR. This is one side. The another side was ultra computers. Okay, ultra computers, which developed into 222 processors parallel. Fujitsu VPP 500, whatever is there, no? It had 222 processors running in parallel. Following ultra computers multiprocessor project, there were BBN Butterfly project, IBM project. All these were a commercial based projects which were using shared memory technology. Okay, this is the one part where shared memory technology started with C.MMP and landed with different others like KSR, BBN Butterfly, IBM RP3. All these projects were ended up. The next another is non-shared memory or message passing track. See, message passing track means here we are not using shared memory or interconnecting networks, inter-processor communication network we are not using, but message passing network we are using. What is the meaning of message passing network? See, there will be parallelly operating computers will be there, or nodes will be there. Those processors will talk to each other through messages. If they want to share data between them or instructions between them, they will be passing the message first, and then after that they will be dealing with the data or instruction. This is how the message passing network will work, or message passing multiprocessors will work. They will be having their own memory and processor. Each will talk to each other. They are not taking the data or instructions from memory, but they will be taking data from their own memory. Okay, that's how they are different message passing network. This is having obviously started with Cosmic Q 1981, if you can see the slide part B, and then Intel took up this work, and they obviously developed a lot in this through Intel IPSCs project, and then Intel Paragon, like that they developed a supercomputer. Okay, this is how non-shared memory or message passing network track is there. And there is a projects like Massachusetts Institute's MIT's J machine also. Okay, latest 92, they had a fine grain two multi computers which were working parallel. This is how non-shared memory or message passing network or message passing parallel computers were working. This is the second track, whatever I'm telling. Next is the track which is related with multi-vector and single instruction multiple data tracks, multi-vector and SIMD tracks. This is the third and fourth tracks which we need to see. Okay, these are actually multi-vector tracks. You know that it will be having vector processor, vector supercomputers. It is a traditional CDC 7600 computer or vector processor system, started with 1970s CDC 7600. Later same CDC Cyber 205 was developed. Okay, and it is ended with ETA 10, a further development. All were massive parallel processing computers. Okay, massive parallel processing computers, another counterpart of CDC 7600 developed upon that is Craven machine. Okay, Cray YMP, Cray MPP, all these massive parallel processing computers were developed based upon CDC7600. That's how multi-vector tracks were observed. Next, single instruction multiple data track, SIMD track. This started with ILIAC 4 SIMD computer. Okay, this is having two tracks, obviously Goodyear MPP and the BSP. These two tracks were there, and then the Goodyear side we have DAP 610, CM2, CM5, all this. And regarding the BSP track, we are having MASPAR MP1 and IBM GF11. These are some of the works which were done with SIMD tracks. Obviously, all these machines becomes the case study for you later in the later chapters. But let us understand that one is multi-vector supercomputer, another is SIMD supercomputer. These two tracks, how they are developed. One started with CDC7600 and another started with ILIAC 4 supercomputer. Then the last part is multi-threaded and data flow tracks. Multi-threaded and data flow track, where we are having, let us understand what exactly is multi-threaded. Multi-threaded, you know that SISD or single instruction single data machines or von Neumann type machines, they will execute one instruction at a time and they deal only with one function. They deal only with one function, not with multiple functions at a time, isn't it? Whereas multi-threaded machines, what they do is multiple functions which are possible to run parallel, they will run it parallel. Okay, this is multi-threaded track. Okay, multi-threaded track. And what about this data flow track? Data flow track or part B, whatever I'm talking, data flow track will be instruction level parallelism. We call it as instruction level parallelism, or granularly instructions level. If we can run parallelly different instructions at a time or at a given time, we will do that. This is the difference, where in the case of multi-threaded, we will be running different functions parallel, whereas data flow track, we will be running different instructions parallel. That is the difference between these two. Obviously, CDC 6600, which was developed in 1964, was the starting point for our multi-threaded tracks. Okay, and later it was developed with HEP projects and Terra and MIT's Alewife projects. If you can see the tracks there, CDC 6600 started in 1964, and then 1978 HEP project, and 89-90 we had Terra and MIT Alewife projects. All these were working with multi-threaded. Today multi-threaded technology is much matured. Okay, it has reached the saturation stage. Almost all the concepts of multi-threaded technology is understood to the world, but there were initial stages where CDC 6600 started in 1964, and later this development had taken place all over these 40 to 50 years. That's what is multi-threaded technological track. Next is data flow track. Data flow track, in data flow track or instruction level parallelism, as I told you, instructions will be running parallelly in different processors. Okay, different processors. That's what is the difference. Now here initially the instruction level parallelism started in 1974. Data flow means what? Not only the data, instructions as well as data, both will be running parallel. Initially started with static data flow in 1974. Later we had MIT project, Arvind and others in 1980, and Manchester project in 1982, where dynamic data flow was started. Initially started with static dynamic flow, static data flow or static instruction level parallelism. Later the concept of dynamic data flow or dynamic instruction level parallelism started. Okay, today we are having EM5 in 1990 around, Project T and EM5 were the different high-ended projects which were worked out. Okay, this multi-threaded technology and instruction level parallelism we will be studying later. These are the tracks of these two, which gives us how static data flow started from Dennis in 1974. Later, it led to different other tracks, maybe MIT's track or Manchester track, where different mature technologies like T or EM5 were developed. Okay, these five slides show you what exactly is the meaning of track. The meaning of architectural track means whatever technology today we are having is based upon some previous works. Those works were taken, on that work further development were made, and that's how today's technology has become a matured or grown up technology. That's what is the meaning of architectural track. Anyway, next chapter onwards we will be studying more on this, that is chapter 2 onwards. I have finished chapter 1 by this class. I hope you are attending the quizzes and other things which I am regularly posting. If any doubts are there, you can reach me on your group or you can mail me regarding that. Thank you. ಯಾರು ಅಡುಗುಂದರೆ ಯಾರು ಯಾರು ಅಂತ